I see no future without technology, but even future without nature, they must find a balance at some point.
This is a statement by Markus Kayser, German designer with a studio in London, who with his latest project SolarSinter has won the Arts Foundation Fellowship 2012. In a world increasingly concerned with questions of energy production and raw material shortages, this project explores the potential of desert manufacturing where energy and material occurs in abundance. In this experiment, sunlight and sand are used as a raw energy and material to produce glass object using a 3D printing process that combines natural energy and material with high-tech production technology. Solar sintering aims to raise questions about the future of manufacturing and triggers dreams of the full utilization of the production potential of the world's most efficient energy resource, the sun. Whilst not providing definitive answers, this experiment aims to provide a point of departure for fresh thinking. Called the SolarSinter, the machine is based on the mechanical principle of a 3D printer. The device uses a large Fresnel lens to focus a beam of sunlight, creating a temperature between 1400 and 1600 degrees Celsius. This is hot enough to melt silica sand and build up glass shapes, layer by layer, inside a box of sand mounted under the lens. Solar-powered motors move the box on an X and Y axis along a computer-controlled path, and a new layer of sand is sprinkled on top after each pass of the light beam. Two photovoltaic panels provide electricity to charge a battery, which in turn drives the motors and electronics of the machine. Light sensors track the sun as it moves across the sky, and the whole machine rotates on its base to ensure the lens is always producing the optimum level of heat. Once all of the layers have been melted into place, the piece is allowed to cool and dug out from the sandbox. Kayser developed the project while studying on MA Design Products course at the Royal College of Art. The first manually operated solar sintering machine was tested in February 2011 in the Moroccan desert with encouraging results that led to the development of the current larger and fully automated computer-driven version, the SolarSinter. In the context of a desert-based community, the SolarSinter machine could create unique artifacts and functional objects and act as a catalyst for the solar innovation for more prosaic and immediate needs. Further development could lead to additional solar machine processes such as solar welding, cutting, bending, and smelting to build up a fully functional solar workshop. The SolarSinter could simply be the starting point for a variety of further applications. Printing directly onto the desert floor with multiple lenses melting the sand into walls, eventually building architecture in desert environments, could also be a real prospect. Experiments in 3D printing technologies are already reaching an architectural scale, and it is not hard to imagine that if partnered with the solar sintering process demonstrated by the solar sinter machine, this could lead to a new desert-based architecture.